Greetings, I am Hubert the Explorer, and today we are looking into the life of a rare breed of creature, the first year Orbitplasty rotatee. Now we see our subject, a 28-year-old Homo sapien Filipino male, scientific name Rainiersis melantensis, or Ren for short. As you see, he is currently waking up at the crack of dawn to prepare for the day ahead. We now observe the rare creature preparing the ritual dark liquid to be consumed by his PLR tribe. He splays the folders for the day's OR and reviews them. He prepares the sacred tools needed, the Orbitplasty set, Ice Cold Plane NSS, a suture set, a lacrimal stent, consent forms signed and checked, and the most important of all, Bluetooth speakers with Spotify set to an 80s playlist. We now observe the seniors confidently coming in. Here, we see the beta male of the group, second in command, scientific name Rainaldsis cunanensis, or Rain for short, and the alpha male of the pack, scientific name unavailable. He is an even rarer creature than our subject, but let us call him Hakobs. Together, they prepare for the day's onslaught of patients. As we can now see, our subject prepares his voice to let out with all his might a war cry. And just like that, another creature, not quite rare, called Patientis hominis approaches. Truly amazing. Inside the clinic, he gets the visual acuity and history of the patient. He does the traditional ritual of a physical eye exam and refers to his seniors, to which they double check the measurements. They then show their tribe leader their findings. Hakobs is now asking Ren a question regarding the diagnosis and proposed treatment of the patient. Uh-oh, there seems to be something wrong. We see the alpha raising his eyebrows at Ren. Ren states his diagnosis. Ren looks at his second year, the beta male, for help. The tribe then discusses with him the diagnosis and treatment options for the patients. We now see our subject dragging his red trolley filled with the tribal tools for the procedure. The subject now prepares the room and the tools for the awaited operation. He then has the duty to take pictures and run for the tools needed. At the end of the day, everybody is tired but satisfied. We see our humble subject cleaning the tools used earlier, reflecting on the proceedings and learnings of the day. He then plays the sound of his tribe, a sound that defines who they are and would enable them to work efficiently and swiftly. And now we have come to the close of the day, bodies tired but hearts filled, mentally exhausted but content and happy. Another day has passed, and more operating procedures to come. This is just but one day in the life of the rare creature, our Orbitplasty first year.